Good morning, good morning, good morning. Happy Friday. We made it to the end of another week. Good morning, Heartbeat Nicole. Good morning, Heartbeat Troy. Good morning, Heartbeat Bernice. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Wherever you are, come on and let's give God a praise. Hey, Heartbeat Elaine and Heartbeat Donald. Good morning, good morning, good morning. You made it to the end of another week. You have, God allowed you to see another Friday. Last night was not your last night. Yesterday was not your last day. Glory to God, for he is good. He's greatly to be praised. Listen, there's nobody like him. Nobody can love you the way that God loves you. Nobody can give you chance after chance after chance. His chances are unlimited. Nobody can look at you and see you as good like the way the Lord does. So give him a praise on this morning. Brand new mercies we see. It's a day that we'll never ever see again. Glory to God. But we choose to rejoice on this morning. Glory to God. I am just so excited about the things of God, about what he's doing for his people. And so I'm just have a praise on my lips on this morning because he is just good like that. Well, listen. And welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness, aka the Heart Gatherer. And this morning, your daily dosage is a continuation of Committed to Living the Abundant Life Part 5. Committed to Living the Abundant Life Part 5. And so we've been talking about what it means to be committed. Like, I'm in this thing. I'm not giving up. It means that I'm going to do all that I have to do. I'm diligent about this thing, about receiving all that God has for me. And so we started talking about the ways to make sure, or the ways to ensure, excuse me, that we stay committed to living this abundant life. And we started out talking about taking care of your temple. We talked about that on Tuesday and Wednesday. And then yesterday, we talked about watch your words. And today, we're going to talk about be your authentic self. Be your authentic self. And so what is authentic? Authentic is the undisputed origin. It's being genuine, not called into question. It's being accepted, meaning this: I'm going to be who God said that I am. I'm not going to try to be anybody else, but I'm going to be me because I can only be me. So I always tell people that apply within to be yourself. Nobody else can be you. You've got to understand this, that God loves us all so much that he gave us all our own set of fingerprints. You know, that we're different, we're unique. And so what we've got to do in order to stay in living and being committed to living the abundant life, you've got to accept you as you are and be your authentic self, whatever that is. If you're funny, be funny. You know, if you got a gift to do certain things, do it. Don't try to do it the way somebody else does it, but be you. Remember, God created you before you were in your mother's womb. He already had a plan for your life. And so he didn't plan for you to, you know, be somebody else. He didn't plan for you to compare yourself to someone else. But he planned for you to be the person that he called you to be. Galatians 6, 4, and 5, the Passion Translation says it like this. It says, let everyone be devoted to fulfill the work God has given them to do with excellence. And their joy will be in doing what's right and being themselves and not in being affirmed by others. So here we go again. He says, it's about what I want you to do, not about you being confirmed by others, but do what I called you to do. It says every believer is ultimately responsible for his or her own conscience. The Message breaks it down and says it like this. It says, make a careful exploration of who you are and the work that has been given, and then sink yourself into that. So find out what it is that God has called you to do. Get to know you and then sink your teeth into that. Don't be impressed with yourself. Don't compare yourself with others. Each of you must take responsibility for doing the creative best you can with your own life. And so this means we're not going to be comparing our lives to others. We're not going to say, you know, such and such did it like this, so I have to do it like this. No, we're going to be our authentic selves, and we're going to do life the way God created us to do it. So if you're trying to be someone else, who's being you? I'm going to ask that question again. If you're trying to be someone else, who's being you? And so you've got to remember that you've got to be your authentic self. When I think about this, I always think about the account with David. When David was getting ready to fight Goliath, you know, and everybody was like, you're this strawny little kid. You're not going to be able to do this. And I'm in 1 Samuel 17, and it starts out in verse 38, I want to say. And, you know, Samuel tries to give David, you know, all of his armor. He tried, you know, he gives him his helmet. He gives him his sword, and David tries to on, but he can't move. And David was like, listen, this ain't my portion. I can't work out with this. This is not who I am. So he takes it all off, and he gets his little 5 smooth rocks, and he's like, I gotta do this thing the way I do this thing. I can't walk in your armor because that is not mine. I can only walk in who I am. I can only do what God has gifted me to do. I can only operate. I can only beat him if I beat him the way that I know how to do it. You know, David was like, listen, y'all calling me scrawny, y'all calling me little, but let me let y'all know. He says, I done killed a bear, I done killed a lion when they tried to come in and steal the sheep. He was like, I got this, you know, because he was relying on God. He was not relying on his own strength. He was not going to compare himself to someone else. But David said, no, I'm going to be my authentic self. Strawny as you all may call me, small as you all may say that I am, you say that I'm just a shepherd boy. He said, but let me show you what this shepherd boy can do. And so you've got to have the attitude of David, that it does not matter how others see you. It does not matter that others may think that you can't do it. You've got to rely on what you know God told you. You've got to be your authentic self and operate in the ways that God has shown you to operate. See, when you are your authentic self, that's when you can get the blessing. That's when you can walk in wholeness, because you're understanding who you are. You're recognizing who you are. You're accepting who you are. And you're good with that. Why? Because you know that you have been created by the Father. You know that you are made in his image. And so in being and dedicated to being committed to living this abundant life, you've got to be your authentic self. Amen. Listen, that's the daily dosage for today. Committed to living the abundant life. But I've got to do that by being my authentic self. Amen. Listen, I see there's some birthday shout outs. Happy birthday to Heartbeat Marcia, who watches on YouTube each and every day. Happy birthday. I pray that God will bless you and keep you. I pray that this today is the first day of the best days of your life. And then I see Heartbeat Troy's birthday is tomorrow. Happy birthday, Heartbeat Troy. Have a great time in God. Know that God's got you. Know that things are going to be better every single day. Know that God has plans for your life. And so happy birthday to Heartbeat Marcia, and happy birthday to Heartbeat Troy. Hey, listen, if you have not subscribed to the YouTube channel, please do so, because there you can find all of your dosages in one place. Follow me on social media platforms, God Wants Me Whole. Visit the website, GodWantsMeWhole.org. Gotta say this, thank you to all of you who shared the post with the Gathering of Hearts, the whole man. I had a great time last night hanging out with the men, and I'm excited about what's coming up on Monday. It's the Gathering of Hearts, the whole woman. Elder Carolyn and I have been talking, and we have something spectacular planned for the women. So make sure that you share that post. Get all your girls. We're going to have a good time. The guys had a great time last night. I had a great time hanging out with them. Listen, make sure you go out there today. Have a spec wow amazing day. Look out for falling blessings, because they are falling all around you. Know that I love you a bunch, and I will see you guys right back here on Monday with a fresh new dosage from God. Again, have a great weekend. I love you guys a bunch, and I will see you on Monday with your authentic self. Again, happy birthday, Heartbeat Marcia, and happy birthday, Heartbeat Troy.